So here is my guide to surviving any scary movie. If you are ever in a situation where you're placed in a scary movie or a scary movie situation, highly unlikely, but just in case, these tips will help you from bleeding out in some godforsaken woods or some dirty ass floor. 1. Don't be the black guy in the movie. Yes, I know it sounds racist, but generally, black guy dies first. So yeah, black folks, avoid the trip to campground swampy poo-poo. And you, unlike this guy taking a dump in a porta pot, some RV campground probably isn't the best move. So yeah, bro, you're gonna die with mud. Sorry. 2. Avoid the scary house. I don't care if it's Halloween. Stay the freak out of the scary house. They say you shouldn't judge a book by its cover. Well, in scary house terms, if it looks like someone or some people may have been slaughtered in the basement, and oh, by the way, it's dirt cheap, best to avoid at all costs. First time flippers, this one ain't the one. 3. Don't be the brave guy. Remember, I said brave, not hero. Often the brave guy thinks he's the smartest in the group. Okay, lifting weights, cage fighting, jujitsu, all that doesn't qualify against the gorilla strong, chunk looking psycho killer. Best believe, you're gonna die, and probably in the most horrible way. More than likely, he is wielding an axe or a chainsaw. So there's no mano a mano here, bruh. Just crazy versus the soon to be dead. Now, as for this guy, who in bloody hell knows why he's in the creepy ass shack in the middle of the woods? Oh yeah, brave guy, aka dead guy, that's who. And FYI, if brave guy disappears in the woods and someone comes up with the bright idea to go look for him, you tell them to shut the hell up. Because it's pretty obvious, Jason the werewolf vampire killer has probably already done his work. And he's a zombie now. So yeah, F him. As for all you DMFs who want to talk to the dead, you are stupid. Nothing more than, nothing less. Clearly, your mama didn't raise you right. Who raised you? I have no idea. And as for the people who like to tell ghost stories, and then you hear, I dare you to go into the bathroom, look in the mirror, and say Candyman, or Bloody Murder, or whatever, 5 times. Yeah, you deserve to get effed up. Man, we should all forget you, just because you were dumb. So, yeah, don't do it. 5. Okay. So you didn't listen to my rule about avoiding the scary looking house, and you decide to do this old house episode, and you're standing around while a swarm of flies come out of nowhere, and then the house says, get out. I suggest you bounce. Burn the house down, run. Now, burning the house down may release whatever may have been in the house out, but hey, that's not your problem, because you're going to move out of state, you're going to leave. You're hasta la vista, baby. You're bye-bye. Rule number 6, the escape plan. Always have an escape plan. You never know when you will be stuck in a house with a psycho killer. And oh, by the way, going through the doggy door, that doesn't constitute a good escape plan. Chunky butt, you're not going to make it. Windows, maybe if you're on the first floor. It's pretty obvious. When in doubt, hide. Be very, very quiet. Don't say a word, and you might survive. Rule number 7, if you're in a foreign country, why would you be in a foreign country? Nature walking, at night, on the moors, I don't know. But if you're in a foreign country, and they say, hey, don't leave the road, my G. Don't leave the road. If you decide to do your own thing because you are shooting the sheets and giggles, then hey, that's your ass, Mr. Postman. Because if a rabid dog or Bigfoot commits to open a can of whoop ass on you, well, you didn't follow the rules, bruh. You get what you deserve. Number 8, if you've paid attention to all the rules, did everything you're supposed to do, and you found a bomb ass hiding spot, make sure you don't have a full bladder. However, if you get scared and have some form of emotional bio release, well, that sounds like a personal problem, and you deserve whatever pain and suffering is coming to you. And lastly, if you're in a Nightmare on Elm Street episode and this involves Freddy, there's nothing you can do. Freddy always wins. So just die real cool so everybody will talk about you the next day. Other than that, unless you find yourself in a Twilight Zone movie, and things tend to go sideways, I provided you the keys to survival. If you haven't already, like, subscribe, and just hit that bell for notifications for all my current videos. Hey, this is Chosen Ill, aka Ryan Matthews, aka Visitor the Vet, saying, see you in the next scary movie.